Hey, what's up, InfoSec Addicts? Joe McCray here with another mentor moment. What's been going on with these mentoring programs? We're doing a lot of them. My God, I had no idea. We've had probably 11 new students sign up just in the last couple of weeks. But let's go through a couple of the things that I'm noticing now. Mentees are asking about certifications and what certifications should they get. The key thing here when it comes to certifications is, what is the story that you're trying to tell a prospective employer? What are you trying to say about yourself? Obviously, if you're just getting started, I'd really be looking at something like your Security Plus, CompTIA Security Plus, because it's a good way to demonstrate basic competency in general security vocabulary. It doesn't mean that you're proficient on the keyboard in anything. Understand that. So if you've passed something like a Security Plus, or you're preparing to do something like a Security Plus, you need to realize what you're telling that customer, that prospective employer, is, I am good with my basics of fundamentals of IT security. I know what a worm is. I know what a virus is. I know what DLP is. I know what these things are. I'm not proficient on the keyboard configuring a DLP solution or configuring a web application firewall, but I know what these things are. It's an introduction to IT security. So a person who does this is going to be a beginner in IT security, and they're not going to be doing a super technical job. They're probably going to be doing like a low-level security analyst job or a low-level information assurance job, where you're essentially just verifying that systems are patched correctly and configured correctly to demonstrate your overall security posture. Now, the next thing is, people say, okay, well, what about my GPIN or my OSCP or so many of these other certifications? What's the story that you want to tell a prospective employer? Is that I understand not just the technical components, but the process of network penetration testing, then yes, your SANS GPIN is a very good cert to get. It's technical. I don't want to say it's not technical, because it is, but it's really more focused around what are the processes involved in performing a network-based penetration test. The same thing for your GWAPT. It's a web application penetration testing certification, but it's going to be really, really focused around, do you understand the processes of testing a web app for application security vulnerabilities? Is it going to make you a ninja who's ready to do bug bounties? Probably not. But if you're trying to show an employer, hey, I'm ready for this type of position where I can be performing these types of tasks, then the answer is, yeah, it's a very good certification to get, and it's very well respected. If you wanted to demonstrate to a customer that you're prepared to do some technical stuff, I would be considering either the SANS GAC-based certs or the eLearn security certs. Now, what's the first drawback that a lot of people run into with these certifications? Obviously, it's cost. So with that in mind, some people will look at something like another company, which is a buddy of mine. His name is Armando, and his company is called eLearn Security. And they've got a series of certifications that are a little bit cheaper. They're just a few hundred bucks per certification. And you want to say it's the exact same thing. They've got a network one, they've got a web app one, and all those types of things. So to throw out some numbers, to make a six-figure salary in the IT security space, that's not uncommon. A couple hundred thousand, a hundred grand, up to a couple of hundred grand, that's possible. Let's say you want to be able to work from home, that's possible. All those things are possible, but they're going to be possible based on how good you are, not the certifications that you get. A lot of people keep asking me, well, I just want to do, you know, cool stuff in security. But I want you to think of it like being a doctor. You can be a general MD, right? Or you can be a specialist. Security is the same thing. Security is a really big, big industry, and it's huge. You can specialize in network-based penetration testing, network-based incident response. You could specialize in web application penetration testing. You can specialize in penetration testing embedded devices. What we've got to keep going at here is, what interests you? Start with what interests you. Let's not focus on what makes the most money. If you're focused on what makes the most money, you're going to very quickly find that you're not going to make the amount of money that you want, because if you really want to make the amount of money and make a lot of money, you need to be really, really good. If you pick a specialization in IT security and you become good at it, you're making a lifelong commitment to become really, really good at it, you're going to make whatever amount of money that is that you want. Let's go back. What's the story that you want to tell a prospective employer? If you want to tell this prospective employer, this is what I'm good at, then this certification covers, then do it. But what if you're like, well, I want to show a particular employer that I'm really good at malware analysis or reverse engineering or a specific subset of that? Then I think the way to go about doing that, and you're going to find that I'm telling all of my mentees to do this. The first thing you want to do, number one, a blog. And in your blog, you're going to write out all of the things that you're doing in your home lab. Because if you're interested in malware analysis or reverse engineering or exploit development or whatever it is, you want to have a blog going through you doing these things. It shows the prospective employer your writing ability, really important, how far you're willing to take a particular thing, how you solve problems. The second thing that you want to build is a GitHub page. That's a repository for all of the code that you write. You really want to do that, because now when you're doing an interview and you're, let's say you're career changing, and you want to be able to show a prospective employer, here's the stuff I've been working on in my home time. Here's how motivated I am. I'm doing this on my own. I'm in a completely different career, and I'm doing this on my own because I'm that interested in it. And then here you can look at the code I've written on my GitHub page. These are going to be the two things that I think are really, really important for showing a prospective employer that they can take a chance on you without this work experience, without this professional work experience. And then number three is join an open source project. You wanna go to github.com and then you wanna search for an open source project that's anything that you're interested in. There's tons of malware analysis projects out there, reverse engineering projects out there, IOC sharing projects that are out there, exploit development projects that are out there. There's so many tools that people are developing. And what I think you should do is join an open source project that is doing something that you're interested in. If you join this open source project and you start working on this open source project, even if you can't code, offer to write their documentation. Offer to be a beta tester for the product and new versions of the product. Get involved. And then you want to put that on your blog. Show that you're a member of this project. Show that you're really serious about moving this project forward. That's going to be the kind of thing, again, that shows a prospective employer, you know, what you bring to the table, that you're a guy or girl who's really, really serious about being good at this and you're passionate about it. Look, there's a ton of people who are really good in this field but have no passion for it. And there's a ton of people who have a lot of experience in this field and they're assholes. You know, it's not someone you want to work with. For you, when you're trying to demonstrate what you're good at, you want to show a prospective employer your writing ability. You want to show a prospective employer your self-motivation, your initiative. You want to show a prospective employer all these cool things that you bring to the table and that you're willing to teach yourself. You're willing to learn. You're a good person to work with. You're a part of the community. These are the types of things that are going to make a prospective employer take a flyer on you, take a chance on you if you don't have the work experience, if you don't have the education, if you don't have the correct certification. Again, we're not saying don't get certification, but what we are saying is it's going to be a little bit more important that you can show some of these other intangibles beyond just the certification, because a certification with no work experience is going to still be really difficult for you to get a job. But if you can show this prospective employer, here's all the things that I bring to the table, my writing ability, my ability to research, my ability to teach myself. These are the kinds of things that are really going to help you get where you want to get. All right, guys, so this is Joe McCrae with your mentor moment. I really hope that this helps you guys out. keep throwing down stuff in the comments below. Let me know the kinds of things that you're interested in doing as a mentee, and let me know where you want to go. We're getting lots of people who want to do some really deep technical stuff. People who want to do bug bounties, people who want to do exploit development, people who want to do like anti-money laundering and some really cool stuff. And I can help you get there. Been recording some of these mentor sessions. We're going to make some of those available online. We've been recording some of the classes. We'll make some snippets of that stuff available online so you can see what these mentees are doing. You know, I really hope you guys like it. All right, you guys, take care.